Hi, I'm Grant Sabatier.
Hi, I'm Jamila Souffrant.
And welcome to The Money Collective, where we dive deep into money and tackle those tough conversations.
We really believe that financial freedom is available for everyone. There's no topic that's going to be off limit. We're going to be diving deeper into the financial topics that are bigger than actually just money. And financial freedom is for everyone. So we're happy to have you here.
So let's talk a little bit about your story.
My story?
Yeah.
Okay, so.
Who are you?
Who am I? Well, I am just a little girl born in Jamaica, the island, not Queens. Not that there's anything wrong with Jamaica, Queens.
Yep.
But I always have to say that just because I'm so proud of being Jamaican.
Sure.
Came here as a little girl, grew up in Brooklyn, New York. So very proud of that.
Right. Yep.
Raised by a single mom, had me at a young age. And I'm just like a girl who dreams big, mm-hmm. who goes after what I want. Hence,
sure.
like this whole like evolution of wanting to reach financial independence and like starting Journey to Launch. And so
yeah.
for me, like I'm a person who dreams big, who goes after my goals and wants the best.
Yeah.
And so I'm striving to do that. And I think I'm there. I feel like, you know, I don't have everything I want, but I'm working on it.
So when did you start getting interested in money? I mean, when was that moment when you were like, you know, money has the ability to help me live the kind of life that I want to live? When did you start thinking that way?
You know, so growing up, watching my mom and my grandmom and like the women especially around me work so hard, it's like I never grew up without, right? I mean, I didn't have everything maybe that other kids had, but I didn't
right.
feel, you know, that I was less than in any way. I
sure.
had a lot of love, a lot of attention, and my mom like poured into me. But with that, I saw how hard she worked to
mm-hmm.
provide for me. And that kind of work ethic was instilled in me, which
sure.
allowed me to see like, you know what, like I want to like have a life where I'm not worrying about where money is coming from. I want to be able to provide for my kids.
Yeah.
So I was always a saver
cool.
growing up because my mom was a saver. My
yeah.
grandmother was a saver. Even if like they were only making minimum wage or not enough, they
right.
saved. So
yeah.
that was instilled in me, luckily. And we didn't talk about money growing up much. It's not
yeah.
like they taught me how to invest or what a 401k is. Like, right. Who
yeah.
really gets that conversation?
Yeah, gets that conversation.
I mean, some lucky kids do it. I didn't.
Yeah.
And so I really got interested in money just from a pure aspect of I wanted to be a millionaire. Kind of
mm-hmm.
like that surface level, I want to be
yeah.
rich kind of
so
feeling.
Me, yeah.
Right? Like, it's like you don't know what that means. I just wanted to have a lot of
right.
money.
Sure.
And so when I started like working
mm-hmm.
at 14 years old, I'd save some of my money. I never like went out and bought like a lot of things. When I got to my 20s, got like my internship. So I think
mm-hmm.
my first kind of stint into like real money per se was getting my internship in college,
yeah.
and I was able to save like a lot of money that way. I had this Inroads internship, so they helped minority students get
cool.
into Fortune 500 companies.
Cool.
So I did that for my whole entire college career.
Right.
On the summers, I used
right.
to work and save that money, and bought my first condo at the age of 22. It
Oof.
Was, you know, very lucky to do so. It was like
yeah.
all the stars aligned,
right.
and that moment, that purchase really jump-started my journey
sure.
into money and like wealth, even though I didn't know it back then.
Right.
So what happened was I was pregnant with my first son. I was 31
yeah.
and in a long commute, you know, driving to New Jersey.
The grind.
The
yeah.
grind. And,
yeah.
you know, one day it took me 4 hours to get home.
What?
Yeah, it was crazy.
Crazy. Yeah. You're like, why am I spending my life this way?
And because I was pregnant. So before the pregnancy, like it was just like, okay, this is what I'm doing. Like it wasn't that big a deal. If I got home at 7 or 8 o'clock, no big deal.
Yeah.
But becoming pregnant and realizing that I wanted more, I wanted to like spend time with my child. Like
yeah.
I did not want to work in an environment. Now, there was nothing wrong with where I worked. It was more like it wasn't my purpose. And
sure.
I knew that.
Yeah.
So realizing that, I think, kind of jolted me to say,
yeah.
what else is out there? There has to be something else. So then I started like researching how to quit my job, how
yeah.
to retire
yeah.
early. I just started putting all these
phrases
in.
So that was the impetus. You felt
it was.
Stuck and you were like, I want to live this different type of purpose-driven life.
Yeah, like
yeah.
so for, you know, and I think for a lot of people that's what happens. Like
mm-hmm.
something happens, like you feel this like urge in
for
you
more,
and you,
for,
yeah,
yeah,
and you kind of maybe you squash it or you ignore it because
mm-hmm.
you just don't know how to bring it out or make
sounds
it true.
Sounds like you kind of woke up.
Yeah,
yeah,
I was awake. I was sleepwalking. I woke up and it took a while. So it's not like I woke up and
yeah.
everything was fine
yeah.
and I was like, I have it all together.
Right.
That didn't work right away.
Right.
It was more like, what could I do differently?
Mm-hmm.
So I started researching or just Googling
yeah.
and fell into the rabbit hole of podcasts and blogs about
yeah.
And you just dove in.
Financial independence.
Yeah, dove into the deep end.
And I was like, where has this been all my life?
Yeah.
And so basically, to get back to your question, it
yeah.
was that kind of moment that really jolted me up and said, what is there? There's more to life
yeah.
than working a job you don't love.
And now you've transitioned to helping others. So you have to have kind of an intense love, I think, to help people transform their lives. And it seems like, you know, you've made this shift, certainly in the last 6 months of now, you know, becoming a full-time entrepreneur, dedicating yourself to this message. What's been the driving factor to all of this sharing and growing that now that you're giving the world?
Yeah, so I, like, honestly, when I first started my journey to launch, it was all just to share my journey.
Yeah.
I had no like big plans to make this like a big thing or my full-time thing. I was gonna share this and hopefully, if you know, make myself accountable to the two people who were reading the blog at the time. And as I started sharing it, people, they got interested. They wanted to know what we were doing. And you know, I started sharing some of my numbers. I didn't share like every single thing, but they were interested because like here was someone who looked like them, who was talking in a relatable way about money, and they wanted to know, how are you doing this? Like, how did you make this shift? And then I started to say, well, I can help other people. So the same thing that inspired me by listening to podcasts and reading people's stories on blogs, I was like, I know I can be that kind of change agent for other people. And I was excited about that because I knew how much it impacted my life, which encouraged me then to step from behind kind of the scenes and share and like put my face more out there.
So have you found your purpose?
Yeah, I definitely believe I found my purpose.
Yeah, no, I definitely share that with you. I think one of the things in my own journey, I always say that if I would look at myself today, like 5 years ago, I'd laugh because I never thought that I would be a mission-driven person. I was always like, oh yeah, that's just kind of an excuse to do whatever you want.
Yeah.
And I really feel in a lot of cases that this mission, this purpose, it found me instead of me finding it. And I always talk about, and I know you've had these experiences, just the reader emails and the listener emails that you get where you realize that maybe something that you said in some way or an idea that you shared with someone gave them a way to see the world and think about the world in a different way. And then they share that love back with you. So it's kind of like you give all of this out to the world and then it comes back to you like tenfold. And those emails that I got from readers, those first ones, they gave me so much more joy than any dollar that I'd ever made in my entire life. Yeah. And I was like, oh my gosh, there's something here. And I kind of fought it initially. I was like, okay, it feels good, but I still, you know, want to make money. And over time, it was just the engagement with the audience transformed me. My parents grew up very poor. My father was like one pair of pants a year poor, no stoplight in his town. Generations of my family lived in rural Indiana. And my parents made the decision after having me. I came along about 7 years after the doctor had told them that they couldn't have kids. And once they had me, they were like, you know, we want to give our son a different opportunity than we've had. So they moved to the suburbs of Washington, D.C. And my mom worked as a secretary for many years at a magazine. My dad cleaned the offices where my mom was a secretary. My dad worked in a mailroom. I was always growing up like the kid who had the least within my community. You know, it was something that I never felt ashamed of. I just always knew that was the case. My mom was actually really good about kind of explaining privilege and why the people around us had so much money, but we didn't. Mm-hmm. On the flip side, money was something my parents fought about quite a bit. It was something that I knew they didn't have a lot of it, so there was stress around it. I remember I was playing on like a travel soccer team and they didn't have enough money to pay like the fee for me to play. And I remember that I was like 7 years old and I remember them talking about it and it being stressful. My parents actually didn't start saving for retirement until they were in their 50s. They're both still working. And I think I grew up in a world where I knew that they were sacrificing so much to give me an opportunity that I never kind of wanted to let them down. Mm-hmm. And so when I was like 24 and had to move back home.
Yeah, that's a big part of your story, right? Like moving back home, because that's one thing we talked about is that you had this feeling when you were in your like your mom's house or your parents' house that you should be doing more with your life, right?
Totally. I felt like they made a lot of sacrifices for me and that I'd let them down. And so I was 24, I was living back home with my parents. I was sleeping in literally the same bed that I slept in as a seven-year-old kid. And I'd come down to dinner and, you know, they'd ask me, you know, how's the job applying process? How's it going? I had no money. They told me they weren't going to give me any money. I'd sent out over 200 resumes and not gotten a single call back. And I could just see the disappointment in their eyes. So there was a lot of emotion beyond just like not having any money and right. moving back with my parents, it was kind of like, oh wow, I've got to kind of change something here. And that was the big break for me in August 2010, where I was like, okay, I'm a smart person, like I'm gonna figure money out. And I realized that so much of what I'd thought about money and the stress I had and the anxiety, I used to have all like anxiety attacks around it, was rooted in the stress that money had in kind of my childhood and how I grew up. Didn't know anything about early retirement, didn't know anything about financial independence, ended up reading Your Money, Your Life, and I was like, whoa, yeah. this might be possible. And then I like to say that a lot of what drove me was kind of the trauma of just being at home and being so embarrassed, as well as just being in crappy jobs that I hated. I got fired twice in the four jobs that I had after college. And I was like, I need to figure out how to live like life on my own terms. And so the cool thing for me is that now, having gone through the whole process and becoming FI, I learned a ton, obviously, about how to get there. I made a lot of mistakes also. I was so hardcore that I didn't ever kind of stop and smell the roses. Mm-hmm. Like I was just like 85, 90 hours a week nonstop for like 5 years. And every day I was tracking my numbers. I was waking up every morning, spending 5 minutes. I called it my money meditation. And like, I was just completely driven by this goal.
Yeah.
The big thing for me now is that we live in a world where the finance industry sells you this idea that you need millions of dollars, or like, you know, Susie Orman saying you need 5 million, or a retirement calculator saying I needed 3.5 million. And how do you even begin to figure out how much money you're going to need when who you are today is very different than who you're going to be in the future? And so I am inspired just in our conversations, and I'm looking forward to going deeper with you, because I think that a vast majority, if not all, of the conversation is focused around what numbers do you need and how do you fill out the spreadsheets? And very little of it is, you know, how can you use money ultimately to live a life that you love? So I'm really excited about this.
Yeah, and I think like as you're talking, you know, I'm thinking that the same way in which you felt like you missed out probably like on a lot of enjoying that journey
yeah.
to financial independence is where my story, I think, can be helpful for some people who want to see how they can, you know, attain their goals, live a life right. they love while they're on the path. Because for yeah. myself, like I'm not FI yet.
Yeah.
But I've been able to now quit my job to pursue yeah. like this passion, like my purpose full time.
Yeah.
And I would not have been able to do that unless I had started this journey.
Right.
Unless we had saved all that money, unless we got smart about our finances, you know, even with three kids living in New York City
right.
with a husband that's a teacher, you know? So yeah. like, it's like one of those things where my mission is to help people see that there's a way to enjoy freedom today.
Mm-hmm.
And enjoy your life today while you're on the journey.
Yeah, and I think we share the mission of financial freedom being available to everyone. And that's one of the cool things about our conversations, is because we're very different. You know, we look different, we have different perspectives. We grew up in different places. You have a family, you have kids. I don't.
Three kids.
Yeah, three kids. let's make that clear. I'm FI, you're not, but you're getting closer. You know, we're at different parts of our journey. And that's what I'm most excited about, to dig in and dive deep and hopefully inspire some people.
Right. And I think the important thing is that acknowledging the fact that there are differences.
Totally.
And we're going to get into like that as we talk
are.
More, right?
Yeah.
Because I think that's the one thing also that turns people off, is it's like, oh, so you're going to pretend there's not like a difference here?
Right.
Like, no,
absolutely.
There is.
Yeah.
But, you know, for me at least, I'm speaking from a point of there is a difference, but
totally.
Let's not let that hold you back. Let's talk about how you can overcome those differences.
Yeah, absolutely. So I'm really excited for this.
Yeah, I am too.